Hello there, guys and gals. The Welsh Hunter here, back with yet another 100% achievement and trophy guide. And this time, it is in the form of Active Neurons 2, an upgraded and all-around better sequel to the already awesome Active Neurons game. Developed by USANIK, published by Sometimes You, this will set you back at a massively small £4.19. Woohoo! The aim of the game is, of course, very similar to the first one, so you need to move around the level to hit the white square to end the gate, to end the level and move on. Now, there are 120 levels this time, and if you think that's big, well, that's because it is. But there are also other obstacles and things to avoid and get past, but again, it's all very simple, and just like in the first game, I give you a choice. Either you can follow the video, or once again, I have the written solution for every single level for all 120 levels throughout the game. Just ain't I nice to you? Am I not nice to you? So as you can see straight away then, go right. Happy days. Now I know you can just press the Y button to see how it's done, but it goes fast and you have to watch carefully and really, ain't nobody got time for that. Either way you choose though, around 2 to 3 hours is all it takes to unlock every achievement and trophy, and that is for simply completing them all. Of course I won't be talking much throughout the video, but only at key points where new enemies or obstacles appear, so I hope this guide serves you well. And with that being said then, like we've already done, we have already begun. And straight off then, I urge you to use the D-pad for one, as you will find it a lot easier. But the principle is still very much the same, so just follow the guide or the written solution and you are golden nuggets. And of course remember, when we get to the later levels as well, when we have to hit enemies and get rid of things, remember to leave it for about a second before doing the next input on the D-pad. If you do it straight away, it won't register and then you'll sort of mess it up and have to go through the level again. But again, I'll just come back to that when we get to a little later level. And then one more thing, as you will notice, there is no noise in this video. That's purely because of copyright. The music got copyrighted, so you can either listen to your own music, but hopefully that shouldn't put you off a nice easy 1000. So in the next level, then we have our first sort of enemy, if you will, which is the moving block. Now, anytime there's something that is in the level, as you can see, I put it at the top. So MB equals moving block. So you'll go down left and then you have to look and avoid that moving block. So very simple, you know, but like I said, I've put anytime there is something in the level, which is distraction, an obstacle, an enemy, I will put it up the top next to where it says level, whatever, point, whatever. So as you see again, MB equals moving block, level 2.7. So go through it, and then as soon as you see that MB, make sure that you can actually get past it before you move on so you don't die. So obviously the more we get into the game, the bigger these solutions are going to be, so I've done it as small as I can, but hopefully it won't get in the way of the video. But like this one for instance, level 6.7, apologies though if it does get in the way. Either way, hopefully you can understand it and you're still having a good time with it. So then, hopefully you're having a good old time with it so far, but it's the next set of levels now, from now until the end, where we have CT equals careful timing. Now with this, there's basically going to be a yellow block that will be moving around, and we need to obviously place certain blocks to sort of redirect its path to either destroy an enemy or unlock a gate for us, you know, something like that. So when you get to where it says CT, again, just like MB, I've got it up in the corner, so up in the top, sorry. So there it is, CT equals careful timing important. So as you can see, the yellow block has to go down, so we have to wait. It's not a case of you have to get it smack on. All we have to do is wait until it either, as you see, destroys an enemy for us, opens up a blocked way for us, and then obviously we can be good to go. So it is very simple when you sort of know what you're doing, but don't rush around thinking that you've got to beat it to something. It's always more of a case of you have to wait for it to do something. So again, you could be there 10, 20 seconds, but don't worry about rushing. You will be absolutely fine. Fine, I tells ya. So then from here on out, there is a new sort of obstacle that we have to avoid, and that is basically a bomb. Now, it is a red square with just black around the edge, and it can stay there for around a second before you get exploded into tiny little pieces and have to do it again. So, of course, obviously, don't take your eye off the prize. Don't take your eye off the screen if you're going to hit one, just in case. Now, don't actually say where there's a bomb on the solution. So of course there it is. So straight away then, as you can see, it's the red squares with the black around the edge. So of course don't stay there for too long. We'll just leave the bomb into the experts. I'm not even saying anything more than that, a fear of being shouted at. Right then, so now we are coming up with only 20 levels left, and basically we've got one more big obstacle which is going to feature a lot in the remaining levels, and that is a code number that we need. So what I would do is grab yourself a pen and paper, or use your phone, whatever, and basically there's going to be two boxes to start off, and then three throughout the level, and then four, etc. But it's basically going to have a different shape on it. So sometimes it might be a star, it might be a moon shape, it might be a hexagon, rectagon, your mum's gone, whatever bloody shape it is. And basically, when you hit that, it'll then show a number, which will only last for about 3 or 4 seconds. So then you'll have to write that number down. Then when we get to the code, or the sort of locked door which we need to unlock, you need to then match that shape and number to whatever you've got written down. So make sure, so there you go, number 3, and that's a sort of a half circle thing. And then I've got a moon, so go down, that's 4. So it's you don't just put in 3, 4, you've actually got to match the number to the code, so make sure to write down the number and write down the shape. So as you can see there, then number 3 was the half circle, number 4 was the moon, and now we can move on. That did actually catch me out first, to be honest. I didn't even realise the shapes were a thing until I wondered why I couldn't get bloody past them. So again, like you see again, I'll just explain very quickly. You'll probably get it with no issues anyway, but you've got the two shapes there. So make sure again to write down the shapes and then the number below or above it or whatever. And then of course just match that to the lock code, and then Bob's your uncle, Fanny's your mum's aunt, whatever the bloody hell the saying is, and you are golden. Also, quick apologies for this one and a few others. This solution is rather big. It also has code numbers for us to decipher, and also the whole careful timing with the yellow boxes. So again, you should know exactly what you're doing by now, but just wanted to apologize in case the solution has gotten in the way of the video. And there we go then, guys and gals. That is Active Neurons 2. Hopefully you have enjoyed the guide. Hopefully it has helped you as well, whether you chose to use the video or the written solution. Either way, hopefully you've got your platinum or your 1,000 out of 1,000. But thank you so, so much for watching, guys and gals. Of course, if this video did help, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget, of course, to check me out on all my social medias as well. Bloody goddamn, what do we have? Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, also on Patreon now as well. All the links for everything will be provided in the description below if you want to come and say hey. But again, thank you so, so much for watching, guys and gals. I shall see you in the next one then. Big love. Also, big shout out to TimG84 for the continued support on Patreon. Thank you very much, mate.